Assalamu alaikum. Dear students of class 5, hope you all are fine by the grace of Almighty Allah. Alhamdulillah, I am also fine by the kindness of Allah the Exalted. Welcome to NIEVS Home School. This is Wahid Noor, Assistant Teacher of Islamic Studies, National Ideal English Version School, Deshit. Today I am going to conduct the class of Islamic Studies for class 5. And today our topic is CSQ, it means competency based short question. This is part 3 from chapter 5. Lecture number 20, HW number 11. My beloved students, last two YouTube classes we have finished 10 CSQ, competency based short question from chapter 5. And before that, we have finished already from the exercise all short question answer. And this is the another part 3 CSQ, competency based short question. And it will be start from 11 to 15, it means 5 short question answer. Already 10 short question answer you got the previous YouTube class. So let's start. What is the question and answer? Question number 11, who was Azor? Answer, Azor was the father of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam and an idol worshipper. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam tried to convince his father Azor and other that they were wrong in worshipping idols. But Azor paid no heed to Ibrahim alayhi salam. My beloved students, when we will discuss in physical class about the biography of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, then it will be more clear who was the Azor. But shortly, if I say, Azor was the father of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, but he was the idol worshipper. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam tried to convince him from leaving the idol worshipping, not only him, the other persons also, but at the last end of the day, he didn't accept his invitation. I mean invitation of Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam, and he didn't accept the oneness of Almighty Allah. Okay, now question number 12. What is Miras? Answer, the divine ascension that Almighty Allah arranged for his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, starting from Masjidul Haram, then Baitul Muqaddas on 27th of Rajab, in the 11th year of prophethood, is called Miraj. My dear students, Miraj is the it's a meeting with Almighty Allah. Almighty Allah invite Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam for meeting with him, and then one night Hazrat Jibrail alaihi salam came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. At that time Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping in Masjidul Haram, and then Hazrat Jibrail alaihi salam carry him, I mean Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from Masjidul Haram to Baitul Muqaddas. You know Baitul Muqaddas in your book front page, this is the Baitul Muqaddas. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping in the Masjidul Haram, which is situated in Makkah, and Jibrail alaihi salam bring him from Masjidul Haram to Baitul Muqaddas. Then in the Baitul Muqaddas they perform prayers. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam lead that prayers, and then from there to ascending to the Almighty Allah. I mean Jibrail alayhi salam carry him to the Almighty Allah. He meet with Almighty Allah. He has seen many of the things like Jannah, Jahannam, and many of the things which is situated to the Almighty Allah. So after seeing, after meeting all of this situation, when he came back, so all of this environment, all of this incident is called Miraj. I hope you understood. Already we discussed in physical class about this topic. Okay, now question number 13. What is called Mu'jiza? Answer, when the prophets are shown the supernatural power by the grace of Almighty Allah, that power is called Mu'jiza. Already you got the knowledge about the Mu'jiza, which is called the supernatural power. Supernatural power Almighty Allah didn't give without any prophet. Those are the normal people, normal person, they have no this type of power. Only Almighty Allah given this power to the prophets, but they can show that supernatural power by the permission of Almighty Allah. For example, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam cut the sun. For example, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam's stick, sometimes that sticks is being the snake, big snake. Sometimes he is touching the water, and the water created water is made by a road. So this type of many of the supernatural power prophets shown only for guiding the human beings to the right path. It was the main way. So this supernatural power is called mujiza. Okay, now question number 14. Which invocation Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam has recited before the ship set sail? Write with meaning. Answer, the invocation. Invocation means dua. Students keep remember, invocation means the supplication, the dua. So the invocation is Bismillahi majreha wa mursaha inna rabbi lagafur rahim. Meaning, this will, this means this boat, this ship, this will move and stop as per Allah's order. Verily, my sustainer is forgiving and most kind. My dear students, when we will discuss in physical class about the biography of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, then you will be more clear, but you know about the incident, the flood held in the time of Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam, 40 days and 40 nights it was continued by the permission of Almighty Allah, and fully earth was under the water. So at that time Hazrat Nuh alayhi salam made the ship by the permission of Almighty Allah. So when he that ship sailed on the water, then Prophet Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam said this dua, Bismillahi majreha wa mursaha inna rabbi lagafurur rahim. Okay, now last question, question number 15. Why the people called a war as Harbul Fiza? Answer, when young Muhammad sallallahu alayhi salam returned from Syria, he became shocked by seeing the horrifying sight of Fiza war. Gambling is Waqas fair was the root cause of this war. It was continued for 5 years. It was means the Harbul Fiza, this war. That is why this war was called Harbul Fiza. My dear students, already we discussed, it is related to the biography of Hazrat Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. When Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was the childhood, when he returned from the Syria to Mecca, then he has seen this situation, people are involving in the war, which is the main cause was the gambling, and it was continued 5 years, and which is called the injustice war. Harbul Fiza means the war of injustice. So that is why this war is called the Harbul Fiza. It was the main cause was the gambling. So that's all for today, my dear students. Now keep attention to the HW number 11. Any two CSQ from here. There are 5 CSQ. You will write any two CSQ. Okay, my beloved students, no more today. Keep practicing at home, and every day you try to learn whatever you are getting in the YouTube class. So to abide by your parents, see you next class, inshallah. Till then, assalamu alaikum.